Hello, I'm Madhu.
And I'm Valentina. And today we are going to talk about twin flames going no contact. And today's video title is called Why Twin Flames Go No Contact. And my twin flame is blocking, ghosting, or ignoring me.
So you want to demonstrate what happens when I go no contact?
Okay. Oh my God, why isn't he texting me back? Oh my God. It's been months. Why isn't he replying to my messages?
Done? Okay. We are still learning to be dramatic. Okay, so this is what happens, right? And it's not that she's just doing it. I believe all of us has done it. You know, I have done it with my false twin flame. And, you know, when I text her and she does not reply, I'm like, you know, what is she doing now? Get into that, you know, mirror exercise mode. Okay, she's not responding. What happened? And she's like, okay, why Madhu is not responding? There is something wrong. I'll do the mirror exercise and heal the block. So what is the core? You know, what is your twin flame showing here? When they are actually not contacting you or ignoring you or, you know, not at all communicating with you. It's basically at the core, it is like your twin flame loves you at their core. They choose harmony with you at their core. And every step that happens on your twin flame journey are for your growth so that both of you can come into harmonious union, right? And this space, both of you choose, you know, by giving to each other so that you can grow into your own divinity, your own union within yourself. That is what they do. And at a core also, you need to go deeper where you are not communicating with yourself, where you are not giving love to yourself, you are ignoring or neglecting yourself, not putting yourself at the first. Okay. So those are the places you need to look within yourself and heal yourself there. I think, you know, Valentina can share and give more insight here.
I actually just want to do the acting part. So what's another example? Oh, they stand you up. Or you would like me to share more?
Hey, you want to share more?
Okay, sure. Yeah. So basically, yeah, when the twin flame is just like ignoring you, when they're not replying to your messages, it just means there's somewhere within yourself where you are not communicating to yourself and you need to dissolve that within, not outside of yourself, because it's not going to be able to manifest outside if it's not already manifested within. So yeah, in this situation, like Madhu is absolutely right, when your twin flame is not communicating with you, and it happens to us too, because we're not in perfect union yet, so we can have a block that comes up, and what can happen? I'm just in the middle of a conversation with Madhu and then he just disappears, so just ghosty ghost.
And in truth,
don't you?
Yeah, and then, yeah, but in truth, I get something else, you know, priority or urgent where I have to give my attention. But basically what happens is, you know, the block or the insecurity within her that crops up when I do all this thing. But I don't have that intention to, you know, cut off or don't respond to her. I'll not dare to do that. That's not my intention, right? Yeah, so, yeah, you know, maybe you need to look into your relationship with your twin flame. Maybe they are just into themselves. They are giving priority into something that is good for both of you. Yeah, it's a block.
When it happens, it's a block. Yeah, yeah,
I agree. I agree. That's a block. First thing, that's a block. If the communication is not happening in a harmony, but I would like to, you know, invite you to look at it in from a place of love, so that you know you can heal it within you rather than blaming yourself. Because most of the time you come to a place that if your twin flame is not communicating with you, there is something wrong within you. So that is the place where I want all of you to put your attention, that there is nothing wrong within you. This is just an experience that you are moving through, which can be healed. It's just a communication block. I have seen that most of the people go into just the throat chakra healing, that is a good part of it to start with, but you also need to go deeper into communication with God and really communicate with God and respond to God's direction, because it is also necessary that when you're asking God, God will guide you that do this. You must respond to that. And when you stop doing that, okay, God guided you to do something and you did not actually acted upon it because of, you know, any kind of fear within you, then one thing, you will stop the channel between you and God. Second thing, you will see that mirroring happening with your twin flame. Your twin flame will stop responding you. They'll start ignoring you because you ignored your inner call. You ignored your inner guidance. You did not act upon it because, okay, I did not act upon it because there is some list of excuses that is there, but you need to bring your energy into how to really act upon it. Because if you cannot make a choice, there is a bigger block there, more than, you know, bigger than even the communication block. Because with your choice, you manifest everything, right? So choose to act on, to respond to your inner guidance, to the guidance of your God, and also respond to anything that your twin flame is mirroring. Because, you know, even numbing out, right, you know, if I am mirroring anything to her, or when she is mirroring anything to me, if I'm like, oh, no, she will, that's her block, she'll do it. So that's where actually I will, you know, numb out. That, okay, I will not do mirroring, you know, that's not going to help our union or even our harmonious union, right? Numbing out is not at all accepted on a twin flame journey. It's not. Just don't numb it out. Even it is like a small thing. First thing is, we are anyway expressive. We are like highly expressive. I am highly sensitive. She is highly sensitive. If she do anything, I just go mad. That is how I feel. You don't have to go mad, right, to feel it.
I get shouted at. I get this feeling like she's about to shout at me.
Because I experience it, you know. It's not like my intention is not to, you know, shout or do anything, but I express it openly, because whatever I feel, I don't hold it back because I don't have a block there. Whatever is there, I express it openly. And I will say that is a healthy thing to do when it comes to your twin flame. Because relationship with your twin flame need not to be like, okay, I'm something and she is something, or he is something and we have to, you know, that's not
fearful.
Like, so, yeah, that's like, you know, yeah, fear-based, absolutely.
And that happens. Be honest,
be authentic, be expressive, because you are communicating with yourself. Just see, like, how will you communicate that to yourself, right? So that is the way you need to relate with your twin flame. Don't hold back anything, just open and say it, okay, this is what, so that you will be able to move through that block, and then naturally the next level of communication is going to establish, because both of you are going to ground in your original state of creation, in your own divinity. So in that, everything is peaceful. So if you are moving through some of the, you know, communication upset, that's okay, feel it. Because when you feel everything, then you can heal it, right? If you just numb it out, oh, my twin flame, I'll not say, I'll not express, you're simply blocking that within yourself, and that is going to take the relationship to a worse energy, which is not good, right? So love yourself, express, open, and that actually helps you to connect also, when you honestly say, so that she will, or your twin flame will connect with you, you know, with your authentic self. You know, they will not be like, okay, I don't know. They will not go into that shell, right? They will know, you know. So then they will do their own inner work, and then both of you will come to the grounding state of communication in peace.
Mm-hmm. And something I would like to just add to that is that, you know, when you're doing your mirror exercise work, they're doing it at the same time, you know? Mm-hmm. And also, if something is upsetting you that you're not being honest with your twin flame about, and you can't even just leave out just a tiny little piece, you have to be honest about like the whole thing. You can't leave any misalignments left untouched. If you do, what's going to happen is you're going to stay stuck in that energy of the part that you've not expressed. Expressing it is good. obviously express in a nice way, in a kind way, but be honest, be really, really honest about how you're feeling all the time. And it means that you'll be able to properly, if you choose to heal it with the mirror exercise, you'll heal that within your consciousness, all of those areas, fully and completely, and then you can come to peace there in the whole area.
Absolutely. Yeah. So go deeper, communicate with yourself, respond to all your feelings, express your feelings. That is what is very magnetic to your twin flame. So we'll come back with another juicy and hot and nice video that can take you closer to your twin flame. And now, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.